The eighth stage of Dakar saw the competitors travel out of Al Duademi and heading north to the city of Hail, covering 678 kilometres in total. 458 of those were competitive. And of those 458 kilometres, the stage was split into two parts with a 179-kilometre liaison in between. With only five stages remaining, the chances of Toby Price and Daniel Sanders winning this year's Dakar were getting slimmer by the day, so making up as much time on Ricky Brabec was critical. For Price, the first half of the stage saw him lose up to 4 minutes and 20 seconds on Brabec, and for the Australian fans, the prospects were looking more grim. Until the second half of the stage, where the tables were turned. It was Brabec who lost time and the stage lead through the rocky sections, whilst trying to keep nearest rival Ross Branch at bay in their fight for the lead. Price made up time on the 95-kilometre section and reeled in the overall gap to Brabec by almost 2 minutes. The KTM arrived into Hail, finishing fifth for the stage, 2 minutes and 18 seconds behind stage winner and teammate Kevin Benavides. Overall in the general classification, he still retained sixth place, but the gap to Brabec is now 29 minutes and 10 seconds.
Yeah, not a bad day. Yeah, nothing too crazy. So, kept on two wheels. The first part was all quite sandy and, it was fun to ride in. And then we had the last little section here and it was just full of stones and rocks. So, took our time and just made sure we stayed in the roadbook. And, it was much a better day in navigation for me, but... still just losing a little bit of time, but all in all, we're happy and it's all good.
Whilst Price was happy with his day, Stage 8 was a day Chucky won't be looking back on with fondness anytime soon. By his own admission, it was a really bad day. He misjudged a direction in the roadbook early in the stage, believing his competitors took a wrong turn and went in another direction. But in fact, it was the Gas rider that took the wrong turn, a common story for his rally this year. On top of that, his body took a battering on the changing conditions and arrived into Hail in 9th place for the day. In the general classification, he still remains in 7th, but with a gap of almost 39 minutes to Brabec, it looks likely that the dream of winning Dakar will have to wait another year.
Very bad stage done by me. It was a bad start. I thought the guys did a wrong line out the front early on, I don't know, 10, 15 Ks in. And then I was in the wrong there and then lost the tracks and lost 3 minutes straight away. So it was pretty frustrating. And then just struggled all day with the body, leg and the bike. So very tough stage in the dunes. But then, and the rocks afterwards really shook me to pieces. So yeah, we just did the best we could. It's just one of those days where you don't feel good and you just try and do the best you can and make it to the finish safely.
In T3 Challenger, there were some big smiles on Glenn Brinkman and Dale Moscott, despite battling with more drive belt issues throughout the stage. At 110 kilometres, the belt let go on a steep climb up a dune, forcing the Australians to replace the belt in 20 minutes. The only other problem was post-stage, when the Can-Am motor in their P8 Sport Zephyr started to misfire badly just 15 kilometres from the bivouac. It was later found to have been a faulty coil pack that caused the misfire. Overall for the day, the On The Brink Motorsport pair finished 25th, whilst dropping two places in the T3 general classification to 23rd. Whilst they like to be higher up in the standings, Brinkman and Moscott have been loving the Dakar experience.